Robotics is a Boston-based company whose flagship product is Kibo, a robot building kit specifically designed for young children ages 4 through 7 years old. The idea is to let kids' imaginations soar, all without requiring screen time on PCs, tablets, or smartphones. With Kibo, children build, program, decorate, and bring their own robot to life. Even the youngest of learners begin by coding with wooden building blocks, creating sequences, and learning design processes. Developed specifically for teachers here at Tufts University, Kibo has proven successful to be in helping kids learn STEAM. That's science, technology, arts, and math. To teach us more, we've invited Mitch Rosenberg. He's CEO of KinderLab Robotics, who brings more than 30 years of experience in the technology industry. Welcome to Urban Update. Thanks for coming in. This is going to be a fascinating discussion here. First of all, just tell me about KinderLab Robotics, you know, how it got its start, and what is the Kibo robot and its mission?
Well, we got our start, believe it or not, at a birthday party for a friend of my son's who was very young, and one of the other parents there pulled me aside and said, are you Mitch Rosenberg? I heard about you. You're the guy who works in high-tech. And I said, yeah, I do. And he said, well, I have a high-tech idea that I think is really important, not just to move technology ahead, but to help our kids develop the kind of literacy necessary to survive in the 21st century. And I was intrigued, and while my son and her son were off playing with their friends, we walked around the block about 100 times, and it turned out that this woman is a professor of early childhood education at Tufts, and for the past 18 years, she's researched how children learn STEM thinking. As you said, science, technology, engineering, and math. And she added A for arts, because her mission was to make sure all kids could think this way, not just the few that want to become engineers. And so Kibo is a robot that implements essentially her 18 years of research, and it consists of a robot body that's pretty simple.
Okay. Well, let's talk about that a little bit. What makes up a robot kit here? We can get into this a little bit.
Well, we want kids to have an experience of technology where they feel empowered and excited by it. So we want to hide nothing. So this is a robot body, and you can see that we show them all the inside circuitry of the robot, the power source, and everything like that. And we invite them to build the robot themselves in a really simple way that even four-year-olds can intuitively perform. And they make the robot specific for what they want it to do. And we have a whole host of these little modules. This one, you might guess, is a sound detecting module because it looks like an ear. And actually, many kids don't know what this is. It's a light bulb that turns the lights on and off. We have many others. And they, as you said, they program them by stringing together strings of these wooden blocks with pictures on them. And kids in every country know what to do with wooden blocks, and these pictures are really easily recognizable.
Fascinating. Talk to me about the importance of learning this, and not only this, but exposing young children to coding, which is really writing programs, what that is, and I guess how that can help them pursue an interest in careers in science and technology.
Well, we definitely want them to consider careers in science and technology, but our mission is actually even broader than that, because people who are not going to be engineers are still going to be interacting with engineering and technology all their lives, and we want them to understand what technology really is and not be intimidated by it. So even if you own a restaurant or an art gallery, you're going to be writing code in perhaps spreadsheets that you use to run your business. So our goal is to make this broadly interesting, not just for the kids that like engineering. And just like a couple generations ago, you didn't have to know how to read and write in order to get a job and live a perfectly comfortable life, but now you do. Well, the new literacy is STEM literacy. And it's not going to be long in the future where you're going to really have to be able to make rudimentary programs and build rudimentary objects in order to complete your job, no matter what career you have.
And also talking about why this kind of physical building of these robots is preferable to for young kids than screen time. You know, kids getting on, a lot of kids they make tablets for toddlers now.
Mm-hmm. Well, what I learned from my business partner, Professor Behrs, is that children's cognitive skills are really not fully developed at early ages. So especially abstract ideas are hard for them, and they really learn better with something that's physical, tangible, and if possible, kinetic movement. So lots of research backs this up. And the problem with screens is it's really an abstract representation of the world.
Now, tell me a little bit more about it, because there's this something about a throwing arm that a lot of the kids have fun with exploring, you know, physics principles and so forth.
Well, it's funny you mention that, because we just announced that this week. I didn't bring one, because we're, in fact, just manufacturing it for the first time. So you can program this robot to throw a ping pong ball, and there's three different ways to set that throwing arm so you can control the trajectory. And we make a game out of it, but kids learn a lot about force, and they learn about angles and momentum without having to learn the complex mathematics.
And again, we're talking about 4-year-olds, 5-year-olds, 6-year-olds, 7-year-olds.
We have 4-year-olds playing with these things that after a few minutes can program the throwing arm to throw the ping pong ball into the basket. We have 4-year-olds that write 25-line programs.
Now, how is Kibo being used in schools, you know, across the nation, what you've seen? And this type of technology education?
So it's being used in schools. It's also being bought by parents and grandparents for their kids. There are a couple of different ways. One way is actually integrated into the curriculum. So I mentioned that art is really an important part of this robot. So you can use art to decorate the robot to look like a character from a book, like Winnie the Pooh, and integrate it into the curriculum that already has Winnie the Pooh in it, for example. You can program Kibo to act out a scene from a Winnie the Pooh story.
Now, what results are you seeing after, you know, for kids who do use this?
So Marina's team at Tufts has done extensive research, and what they found is that kids are more enthusiastic about STEM ideas and more skilled at key elements like sequencing and conditional logic.
Fascinating. And so who's buying these kits, and, you know, where have you shipped these kits to?
We've shipped this in 50 states and 54 countries in the past 5 years.
That's really amazing. And just getting back to this whole thing, again, coding, this whole concept of coding, which is writing programs, is it not?
That's exactly what it is.
And again, the importance of kids learning how to do that.
Coding is essentially a new kind of literacy, and it has its own grammar. And even with a simple language like this building block-based language, you can learn the logic of that grammar and apply it to more sophisticated languages later in your life.
Okay, just to wrap things up, anything else you want to add at all?
Well, at this age, kids absolutely love learning this stuff. There's no way you have to drag them to it, and you have to pry the kids out of the kids' hands at the end of the day, so they're having a great time while they're learning.
Okay, Mitch Rosenberg, CEO of KinderLab Robotics in Waltham, Mass. Okay, thanks for coming in. 5 years going with the company, eh?
5 years, wow. Last month.
All started at a birthday party. That is amazing. Mitch, thanks for coming in.
And thank you.